This mixed linkage beta-glucan test kit, KBGLU, allows for the specific measurement and analysis of 1,3,1,4 beta-D-glucan in cereal grain, milling fractions, wort, beer and other food products. Following extensive interlaboratory evaluation, this method was adopted as AOAC 995.16 and AACC method 3223.01. This video tutorial will demonstrate the use of the kit with a cereal sample and the barley kit control. The kit contains sufficient reagents for 100 assays and is supplied with a detailed data booklet. The principle of the mixed linkage 1,3,1,4 beta-D-glucan assay procedure, also known as the oat and barley beta-glucan assay procedure, is shown in this figure. The mixed linkage beta-glucan is hydrolyzed by lichenase at the position shown by the arrows to produce mixed linkage beta-gluco-oligosaccharides. These are then hydrolyzed by beta-glucosidase to glucose. D-glucose is quantitatively measured with glucose oxidase peroxidase, GOPOD reagent. The amount of D-glucose measured is stoichiometric with the amount of beta-glucan in the sample. Enzymes employed must be absolutely devoid of activity on starch, maltodextrins and sucrose. Prior to sample analysis, prepare the required additional reagents as described in the kit data booklet. Subsequently, once all of the additional reagents have been made, the kit components should be prepared, and once prepared, they are ready for use in the assay procedure. Use the contents of bottles 5, 6 and 7 as supplied. The contents of bottle 1, lichenase, is diluted to 20 milliliters with 20 millimolar sodium phosphate buffer pH 6.5. The diluted enzyme is transferred to a polypropylene tube labeled accordingly. Cap the tube and mix thoroughly. The contents of bottle 2, beta-glucosidase, are diluted to 20 milliliters with 50 millimolar sodium acetate buffer pH 4. The diluted enzyme is transferred to a polypropylene tube, labeled accordingly. Cap the tube and mix thoroughly. Dilute the contents of bottle 3 GOPOD reagent buffer to 1 litre with distilled water. This is solution 3. This should be used immediately. Dissolve the contents of bottle 4 GOPOD reagent enzymes in approximately 20 milliliters of solution 3. Quantitatively transfer this to the graduated cylinder containing the rest of solution 3. This solution can be either a very light pink or a light yellow colour when freshly prepared, and upon storage it will turn to a very light pink colour. This is the glucose determination GOPOD reagent, which is stable for approximately 3 months at 2 to 5 degrees Celsius. Transfer to a 1 litre Duran bottle and cover with aluminium foil. For longer term storage, divide into approximately 250 milliliter aliquots and store at minus 10 degrees Celsius. This is stable for greater than 12 months at minus 10 degrees Celsius and should not undergo more than one freeze-thaw cycle. In the beta-glucan analytical procedure, it is essential that the sample is milled past a 0.5 mm screen. Ensure the sample is mixed thoroughly by stirring with the spatula prior to sampling. Accurately weigh approximately 100 mg of Mills sample into a 16 by 100 mm glass test tube. And record the exact weight. Tap the tube to ensure that all of the sample falls to the bottom of the tube. In this demonstration, we are using a serial sample in duplicate and the provided barley kit control in duplicate. Wet the sample with 0.2 milliliters of 50% volume per volume aqueous ethanol. Mix thoroughly by stirring vigorously on a vortex mixer. Add 4 milliliters of 20 millimolar sodium phosphate buffer pH 6.5 and mix thoroughly on a vortex mixer. Upon mixing, immediately place the tube in a boiling water bath and incubate for 60 seconds. Cover the tubes with caps or parafilm. Tighten the caps and vigorously stir the mixture on a vortex mixer and continue to incubate at 100 degrees Celsius for a further 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, remove the tubes from the boiling water bath and mix vigorously on a vortex mixer. Incubate the tubes at 50 degrees Celsius and allow them to equilibrate to temperature for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, add 0.2 milliliters of lichenase enzyme, prepared bottle 1, to each tube. Mix vigorously on a vortex mixer and return to the water bath. Add a 3 by 12mm stirrer bar to each tube. And replace the caps. Incubate the tubes with stirring for 1 hour at 50 degrees Celsius to ensure all of the beta-glucan is swollen and hydrolyzed by lichenase and solubilized. For samples which contain a very high level of beta-glucan content, the beta-glucan can form gel particles that stick to the side of the test tube. Therefore, with these samples, it is important that the tubes are vigorously stirred several times on a vortex mixer during the lichenase incubation to allow the lichenase enzyme to come in contact with the beta-glucan to break it down into soluble oligosaccharides. After the 1 hour incubation, remove the caps from the test tubes and add 5 milliliters of 200 millimolar sodium acetate buffer, pH 4. Mix vigorously on a vortex mixer and place at room temperature. Allow the tubes to equilibrate to room temperature for approximately 5 minutes. Centrifuge at 1000G for 10 minutes. Carefully and accurately transfer 0.1 milliliter aliquots in triplicate of the centrifuged extract to the bottom of labelled 16 by 100 millimeter glass test tubes, labelled appropriately as the reaction in duplicate and a reaction blank tube. It is essential that the 0.1 milliliter of sample solution is dispensed accurately and directly to the bottom of the tube. When using positive displacement pipettes, steadily push the dispenser plunger to the first stop position. Then push to the second position to ensure all solution is completely dispensed. Add 0.1 milliliters of beta-glucosidase enzyme prepared bottle 2 to the two reaction tubes. to the reaction blank tube, add 0.1 milliliters of 50 millimolar sodium acetate buffer pH4. Stir thoroughly on a vortex mixer. Incubate all tubes at 50 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. During this time, the beta-glucosidase enzyme hydrolyzes the beta-gluco-oligosaccharides to glucose. During the incubation period, prepare the GoPod standard and blank solutions by adding 0.1 milliliter of 50 millimolar sodium acetate buffer, pH4, to tubes in quadruplicate for the glucose standards and to tubes in duplicate for the reagent blank solutions. Subsequently, add 0.1 milliliter of distilled water to the reagent blank tubes and 0.1 milliliter of the glucose standard solution at 1 mg per milliliter, bottle 5, to the glucose standard tubes. After the 10-minute incubation period, remove the tubes from the water bath and add 3 milliliters of GoPod reagent to all tubes, including reaction tubes, reaction blank tubes, reagent blanks, and glucose standard tubes, and incubate at 50 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes. Measure the absorbance of all solutions at 510 nanometers against the reagent blank. The absorbance readings of the sample and the blank reactions are used to calculate the beta-glucan content of the samples. When performing this test on the MegaQuant Wave Spectrophotometer, the absorbance mode feature must be used. The results will be printed via the onboard printer, or the data can be exported to a computer using the SF Capture software. Please see our MegaQuant Wave video for further details. In absorbance mode, the results output are raw absorbance values for both blank and samples. Therefore, the calculation of beta-glucan content can be performed manually, as described in the calculations section of the kit booklet. Megazyme has also developed specific Excel-based MegaCalc applications for each Megazyme kit to allow quick and easy results analysis. Results can be analyzed using the MegaCalc application specific to this beta-glucan assay kit, which is available to download free of charge from the Megazyme website. The MegaCalc spreadsheet provides full instructions for use. Open the MegaCalc worksheet and input the following. Sample details. Absorbance readings for the D-glucose standards. For each sample, input the sample identifier. For each sample, input the absorbance values recorded for the reaction blank. For each sample, input the absorbance values recorded for the sample reactions in duplicate. Alter the sample volume if a volume other than the default 0.1 milliliters is used. If dilution of the sample has been performed prior to the GoPod assay, then input the dilution factor used. If no further dilution was performed, the dilution factor is 1. Input the sample weight used. Alter the extract volume if a volume other than the default 9.4 milliliters has been used. When all of the data has been entered, the concentration of beta-glucan in the sample is automatically calculated and given as grams per 100 gram on an as-is basis in the original sample. If the moisture content of the samples is known, input the moisture content percentage. When this additional data is entered, concentration of beta-glucan is automatically calculated and given as grams per 100 gram on a dry weight basis. For further information, the summary of a collaborative study on the determination of beta-glucan in barley and oats by streamlined enzymatic method is discussed in detail in a paper by McCleary and Mugford.